This is the constructional diagram of three-phase autotransformer. Here is an input side, nothing but primary side. Here output side, nothing but secondary side. In input side, there is a three phases R, Y, B. Again, in output side, there is a three phases R, Y, B. In input side, the voltage is 440 volt and the output side the voltage is variable, which is in three phases. Therefore, this transformer is nothing but three phase autotransformer. Autotransformer has only one winding, which is considered as input and output. See here, this is a winding which is considered for input as well as output. Next, there is a one common movable contact. This is what your movable contact to vary the output voltage. Next, as the contact move anti-clockwise and clockwise direction, the output voltage get changed. See here, if this contact is move in clockwise direction as well as is anti-clockwise direction, the output voltage is changed. The working principle is same as that of normal transformer, which works on Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. The working principle of three-phase autotransformer is same as that of normal transformer, which works on the Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. Now, after the discussion of introduction part of three-phase autotransformer, we go towards the how autotransformer provides a variable voltage. See here, the input voltage is what? 440 volt and the output voltage is what? 300 volt. However, see here, the movable contact is at the top of winding. Therefore, number of turns consumed by secondary side is more. Therefore, output voltage is what? 300 volt. Now see here, again here input voltage is what? 440 volt. Movable contact is at middle position, therefore output voltage is what? 220 volt. However, the number of turns consumed by secondary side is less as compared to this previous diagram. Therefore, output voltage is less as compared to this previous voltage. Again, in next diagram, again same voltage is there, which is 440 volt. Here movable contact is at the bottom side of winding, therefore number of turns consumed by secondary side is less as compared to previous one. Therefore, output voltage is what? 150 volt. From this three diagram, we conclude that here input side voltage is 440 volt, and here also 440 volt, and the output side voltage is in first one 300 volt, second one 220 volt, and third one 150 volt. From these three, we can conclude here this output voltage is decreases because this movable contact move towards the lower points. See here. Therefore, turns consumed by this contact is reduces. As number of turn decreases, output voltage also decreases. Thank you.